Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel RF Design Basics. Today we are going to study about single stage transistor amplifier design. And first of all, we will be designing a transistor amplifier for maximum gain. Maximum gain means when the input and output both are conjugately matched. That means the input reflection coefficient is equal to conjugate of source reflection coefficient and output reflection coefficient is equal to conjugate of load reflection coefficient, then input and output are conjugately matched. So let's just quickly derive it. We can write gamma s equal to gamma s conjugate equal to gamma n. So gamma n we already know, s11 plus s12 s21 gamma l by 1 minus s22 gamma l. Similarly, we can write gamma out in place of gamma l conjugate, and gamma l conjugate will become this expression. Let us take conjugate of the first expression, gamma s conjugate. So conjugate of conjugate will become gamma s, and this side we have conjugate in each and every term. So this can be further simplified in terms of just gamma l, so that only one term will have with gamma l. So divide the numerator and denominator with gamma l conjugate. So this will convert to this. And we already know gamma l conjugate from the second equation. So this gamma l conjugate can be substituted here and can be converted to gamma l conjugate, which is equal to S22 minus delta gamma s by 1 minus S1 gamma s, where delta is again determinant, which is given by S11 S22 minus S12 S21. Now this, after substituting the gamma l conjugate here and doing this derivation, we can solve for gamma s. Since we have already replaced gamma l, so we have only one variable gamma s. So we can solve for gamma s and we will get the solution of this as B1 plus minus under root B1 square minus 4C1 square divided by 2C1. Similarly, we can write this for gamma L. That means after solving the second equation, same as the first equation, we can get this equation where B1, B2, C1, C2 are different constant. B1 is a real number, B2 is a real number, C1 and C2 is a complex number. So by using these formulas, we can find gamma s and gamma l. Once we know gamma s and gamma l, we can easily do input and output matching network. Now let us take a problem where S parameter at 5 GHz of a transistor is given as S11 is 0.66 angle minus 142 degree. This is at 5 GHz. S12 is given as 0.03 angle 62 degree, and S21 is given as 2.39 angle 54 degree, and S22 is 0.72 angle minus 68 degree. First of all, we have to find whether this transistor is stable or unstable. If it is unconditionally stable, we can go for designing the input and output matching network. If it is conditionally stable, then also we can design, but we have to specify that this particular load value and source value is not possible. So in this case, first of all, we will find delta, which is S11 S22 minus S12 S21. So to calculate that, let us store this value in A, B, C and D. So for that, let's type 0.66 angle minus 142. I have already put the calculator in degree mode. Now we can store this value in A, Similarly, S12 is 0.03 angle 62. Let's store this in B. Then S21 is 2.39 angle 54 and store into C. And S22 is 0.72 angle minus 68 and store into D. Now calculate the delta. To calculate delta, we will call A into D minus B into C and convert this into complex form. So we will get a value 0.417 angle 155.5 degree. So we'll write this as 0.418. So this is 0.418 and angle is 155.5 degree. Now we'll calculate K. K is 1 minus S11 square minus S22 square plus delta square divided by 2S12 S21, which is 1 minus 0.66 square minus 0.72 square plus 0.418 square divided by 2 into 0.03 into 2.39. So it's 1.54. So this is greater than 1 and delta magnitude is mod delta is less than 1. So the transistor is unconditionally stable and we can find its gain. G naught is S21 square, GS is 1 by 1 minus gamma S square and GL is 1 by 1 minus S22 gamma L square, 1 minus gamma L square divided by 1 minus S22 gamma L square. So using these three formula, we can find the gain of this transistor. Now let us move into the matching circuit. So for that, we need to calculate these values B1, B2, C1, C2. So let's calculate B1 and C1. So B1 is 1 plus B1 is 1 plus S11 square S11 square, so 0.66 square minus S22 square, 0.72 square and minus delta square. Delta is 0.418 square equal to B1 is 0.742. So I'll write B1 is 0.742. I will calculate B2. In B2, there is just a plus minus sign difference. I'll just write this as plus and this as minus. So this will become 0.908. Then next one is S11 minus delta S22 conjugate. For this, S11 is saved as A. So I'll recall A minus delta is 0.418 angle 155.5 degree, then bracket close, into S22 is D and conjugate of this, so complex form to conjugate of S22, so S22 is D, bracket close, convert this into polar form. This value is 0.36 angle minus 146.5. So C1 is 0.36 angle 146.5 minus 146.5 degree. Then we have C2. C2 is 22 is D, it's called D, minus bracket open 0.418 angle 155.5 degree bracket close multiplied with S11 conjugate. So conjugate of S11 is A, bracket close, convert into polar form, and this is 0.446, magnitude is 0.446 angle minus 71.4 degree. So now we can apply this gamma S and gamma L, B1, C1 value, and we can find gamma S and gamma L for this. So let us see how much is the value. So first of all, let's calculate this B1 square minus 4C1 square. Since B1 is already a real number and C1 is the only complex number, so numerator will be only real number. So let's write that. So gamma S will be B1 0.742 plus minus under root 0.742 square minus 4 C1 square. C1 magnitude square, 4 into 0.36 square, and divided by 2 into 0.36 angle minus 146.5 degree. Then we can calculate this gamma S. Zero point seven four two First I'll take plus and then we'll take minus. Plus under root 0.742 square minus 4 into 0.36 square and divided by 2 into 0.36. Angle can be taken in the top. So this is 1.279 angle 146.5 degree. Another one we can find. This is gamma s first value. Another value can be taken. The first one, second value will be taken by considering this minus sign. So we'll go to the plus and change it to minus. And we'll see the value. So this value is 0.781. So just I'll write 0.78. Angle is same, 146.5 degree. Since this magnitude is greater than 1, this value will not be considered. And this will be our gamma s value, possible value. Because reflection coefficient from the source should not be more than 1. Next we will calculate gamma l. Gamma l is from B2, so 0.908. plus minus under root 0.908 square minus 4 into 0.446 square divided by 2 into 0.446 angle minus 71.4 degree, which we can find out using the calculator again, will be 0.908. let's take plus first and 0.908 square minus 4 into 0.446 square divided by 2 into 0.446. so this is again 1.2 angle 71.4 degree, which is greater than 1. So gamma l second value we are going to take by taking this minus sign, and we will change the sign here. So we will change the sign from plus to minus and calculate it again, and we have got it as 0.8276. so I'll write 828 angle 71.4 degree. So we have got our gamma s and gamma l value. We will write this on a Smith chart and we will do the matching. So let's write gamma s, which we have got as 0.78 angle 146.5 degree, and gamma l as 0.828 angle 71.4 degree. So to do the matching, first of all we have to find the radius of this Smith chart, and it is calculated as 7.6 centimeter. R is 7.6 centimeter. We'll take the first line here for calculation from the center to the first circle. So R is 7.6 centimeter. So for matching the input, that means gamma s, we have to take 146.5 degree angle. So let us find out 146.5 degree angle. So 130, 140, 44, and this is around 46. So I'll draw a complete line from this side to this side. And now gamma s is 0.78. Gamma s is 0.78. So write 0.78 multiplied by this 7.6 centimeter. And we will get 5.9 centimeter. So we'll mark the point at 5.9 centimeter. This is 5.9 centimeter at center. So this point is our, this point is nothing but our ZS or gamma S. If we go same distance in the opposite side, we will find the stub YS. So first of all, we will be drawing the VSWR circle which is passing through this only in this side. So this is our VSWR circle. And mark the point where it is cutting the 1 plus JV circle. 1 plus JV circle is the circle which is passing through the center of Smith chart. So this is the cutting point and extend it till outside. So this is how we can do the input matching. Now we have to just find length of the stub which is required to do this. So starting from 0 lambda here, read the value here, this 0.19. 192, 194 is approximately 0.196 lambda. And here it is 0.29, so it is 0.298 lambda. So the distance between these two is distance of stub, and for the length of a stub we will take this point and move along the resistance circle here to reach at the edge. So this reading is 0.188 lambda. So I am going to draw the circuit, matching circuit here in another page, and I will be writing the corresponding values. So the matching circuit will be these are all 50 ohm lines, 50 ohm transmission lines. So open circuited here, and the source impedance is 50 ohm and load impedance is 50 ohm. We have to find this length. So from here we can see this is 0.298. Initial it was at 0.196. So we'll just take the difference, 0.298 minus 0.196, and it comes 0.102 lambda. So this length is 0.102 lambda. Now next one is from 0 lambda to 0.188 lambda. So it will be 0.188 lambda. Let us move to the load matching. For load matching, I am using another Smith chart. For the gamma L equal to 0.828 angle 71.4 degree. So let's find that point on the Smith chart. First of all, angle is 71. So this is 71. This is 70, so I have taken 71 angle. We need to read in the load reflection, angle of reflection coefficient. So here you can see 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. I have taken 71 degree. Now 0.828. Again the same radius is there. So 0.828 multiplied by 7.6 centimeter. This gives 6.29 or 6.3 centimeter. So this is 6.3 centimeter. And also we will extend this line to opposite side to get YS. So 6.3. So this will be 6.3 here. And we'll mark this as YL. This is ZL and gamma L. Now we'll draw the circle which will pass through this. So this is VSWR circle. So this is VSWR circle which is passing through ZL as well as YL. Now we will start from the origin and we'll go to the cutting point of this. So one cutting point is here and we'll start from the origin. So follow this path. And from here, we can extend the line up to this. So we need to draw one more line, which will pass through the cutting point. And another line, which when we extend this, so it will come here to the outside of the boundary, that means zero resistive part. And reactive part will remain same. So if this value is, let's say, 1 plus J2.9, this will be also 0 plus J2.9. So from here, we will extend this again. And we'll read the lambda value. It's 0.1967 lambda. And this value is 0.202 lambda. And here we can read this as 0.41 lambda, 42 lambda. Sorry, 402 lambda. So we'll use the calculator to find the distance and length. So it's 0.402 minus 0.202. So it's 0.2 lambda, which is the length of the star, sorry, distance of the star. And the length of a star will be 197 starting from 0. So it's 0.197 lambda. So this is how we can design the matching network. The length of source star will be 0.188 lambda. And distance of source star will be 0.102 lambda. Similarly, at load end, length will be 0.2 lambda and distance of the star will be 0.2 lambda and length of the star will be 0.197 lambda. Thank you.